And how's it going, guys? It's Josh, aka Olufemi. I literally just bought a Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 4K, and I'm gonna show you 10 dope run and gun filmmaking tips. So I had a spur of the moment opportunity to test out my new camera at my bro Ace's barbershop, and I decided to go for it. Shout out to Ace of Fades LA over on Melrose out here in Hollywood. So here's the deal though. I had no plan, I had no control over the set, and I couldn't shoot for long because I didn't want to bother any of his customers any longer than necessary. So basically, I had one hand tied behind my back. Welcome to the world of run and gun filmmaking. We've all been here. So I basically wanted to create a really, really short, like 30 second simple piece for their Instagram. This is what it ended up looking like. So, what are some tips I could go by to ensure that I'm still able to create dope content when I'm in a run and gun situation? Number one, think up a quick, simple narrative. When I mean simple, I mean like really simple. I mean like guy pushes off wall, walks down the street, and takes a photo. Yeah, these may just be 30 second videos, but that little direction that a really, really simple narrative gives makes your short pieces memorable and engaging. Number two, use the process shooting technique. I covered this in a past video, but it basically involves breaking down individual actions into several mini actions, then shooting those mini actions from every angle possible, then cutting them together in order really fast. This creates a surreal, seamless, omnidimensional mega action. Like say one action is the cutting of someone's hair. One of the mini actions could be giving a fade on the side of someone's head. You can get a wide shot, a close-up shot, and then a shot from the other angle. Cut all those shots up together really fast and tell me how that looks. Number three, try to shoot the entire thing handheld. Yep, I know you just bought your Ronin S or your Ronin SC and you just can't wait to use it. Well, I've been going mostly handheld for almost 4 years now, and I promise for stuff like this, it'll give you more control over your camera, will make you less conspicuous, and simply just lets you get in and out of a space like 10 times as fast. Number four, try to get shots in one take. Don't linger around people and keep moving. It makes people more comfortable and more likely to stay looking natural. Practice letting go of that OCD temptation to get a safety shot when doing shoots like this. In my experience, more than often than not, the first shot is actually not as bad as you might have thought it would have been. Number five, it's all about capturing not only the actions, but also the reactions. Basically, make sure that you not only capture the action of someone cutting someone's hair, but also the reaction of the happy client looking in the mirror in awe of his new hairdo. Another example, don't only capture the guy making the incredible three-pointer, but also capture the adoring crowd with their mouth agasp. Missing to capture reactions is a massive rookie mistake. Number six, scope out the lighting and adjust accordingly. The number one thing you want to look at is whether there's mixed light temperatures on your set. This can kind of suck because it can make white balancing a challenge. So in the barbershop I was in, I had warm tungsten internal light lighting the back of the barbershop, competing with blue sunlight lighting up the front of the barbershop. I remember I wasn't quite sure which light to white balance to. Bouncing to that daylight would make the back look too orange, and then bouncing to the tungsten would make the front look too blue. A possible solution could have been to just turn off the orange tungstens to keep the constant daylight temperature from the sunlight, but the shop I thought was too deep, and I figured the sunlight wouldn't get to the back of the shop, and the back of the shop would just remain too dark. Therefore, I just decided to bounce to daylight and then isolate that resulting ugly orange tint in the back of the barbershop in post, and then just bounce it separately. This is easier than you think. I'll cover it in a future tut, but basically you're doing something called secondary color correction. Number seven, try to incorporate consistent speed and smooth lateral movement or forward and backward movement in every shot. When the consistent speed and the smoothness of the movement ends, the shot then ends. Don't use any ugly shakes in your final edit. Shooting 60 frames per second and slowing it down in post also helps with creating smooth movement. So I also use warp stabilizer a lot and it works like a charm. Number eight, try to incorporate speed ramping to seamlessly transition in between shots. This beautifully hides cuts, focuses the viewer's attention to a specific action in the shot, and it's significantly less distracting than other transition techniques. An easy way to speed ramp is just adjust the speed of your footage to like 250%, and then cut the footage where you want the speed ramp to end, and then change the resulting speed on the resulting bit of footage back to 100%. Number nine, another editing trick I used was zooming into things in post. Notice how I zoomed into the sign at the beginning, then I zoomed from a faraway shot of Ace to a close-up shot of Ace later in the video. The zoom is just another engaging way to hide a cut. I literally just keyframed the scale in Premiere. Number 10, another thing that you may notice is I complicated several visual cues with some artificial audio cues. The zooming in, I complemented with a whoosh sound. You may have noticed that door chime sound I added at the beginning. And then I added some ambient noise of people talking and laughing, and I also added some hair clipper noises to a couple of shots. Adding these noises in artificially was better than just using the audio from the footage, because it allowed me to isolate each noise separately and control their individual volumes. Basically, I couldn't make the hair clipper noise pop out of the ambient noise in the footage audio like I wanted, because it had all been baked together. So I had to just recreate all those sounds from scratch. Bonus tip, guys, an easy garnish I like to add to my sound effects is adding a low pass filter to the main music track during my establishing shots outside. This gives the appearance that the sound is emanating from the inside of the building and can't be heard clearly until the viewer enters the establishment. Just adds a little bit of depth to the sound design. So guys, hopefully some of these tips can help you on your next run and gun shoot. If you're looking for some dope sound design options, transition packs, title packs, intro templates, stock footage, and anything else you can think of, you can support the channel by checking out Envato Elements. You get unlimited downloads for $33 a month, and through my channel you can get the first month for only $9, and you can cancel literally any time, guys. Feel free to like this video, click subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and as always, remember to keep it chill.